Hi, I'm May. I'm the inventor of the YardPup-Ultimate poop scoop for dogs. This is a side project. It's an ammo can camp stove. On this side, you see the secondary air intake and then a small little rotary damper that I added. I modeled this after Random Chris on YouTube. So this is me trying to copy his idea. There's a little grate inside. I put some stuff on my stove that Chris didn't have on his, such as that little rotary damper. I also relocated the handle so that I'd have a surface for putting a coffee pot. And then I added this damper to the flue. My flue and my air intake are 3 inches. That's different from Chris as well. So this is the air intake, and that's where you can add sticks or pellets, as well as it's the primary air intake. Then on the bottom of the can, I added an ash clean out. That's different from Chris. I also added feet, and then you can put feet extenders inside those square little feet, and it'll make it taller. So that was the basic idea, but it did not work, and I will show you. Okay, so this is burn number one. I'm about 40 minutes into the burn, and you can see just a tremendous amount of smoke coming out from the flue. That's acting right, although some smoke is coming out from the intake as well. And if I'm going to use this in a tent or a camper, I don't want any smoke coming into the area. I'm not sure if maybe I didn't seal it well enough on the baffle. I'm not sure if my reburner is even working. This got to a max temperature of 450 degrees, so at least it burnt off all the paint and kind of settled everything in. I'll let it cool off now and then do a post-mortem, make some changes, and try it again. Okay, so since my initial burn was very disappointing, I made some changes that I hope will help the situation. So first of all, I thought maybe it's not getting to temperature. And so on the bottom, I put an extra piece of steel as just extra insulation. I had to trim the grate a little to fit everything in. I also made some adjustments on the latch, bent that better so that it latches tighter. And then the biggest difference, I think, is up here. I put some fire gasket here so that there's absolutely no smoke leaks between here and the smoke's forced to come up through here. I also soldered the connections the best I could on the reburner, the copper reburner. And then I also put a pipe clamp here just to keep it extra secure. This I'm gonna keep closed. And then another big change is I made a damper for the flue. So I'm gonna give it another try and see if I can get it to emit nothing but steam, which is what it's supposed to do. I wanted to point out those holes that are on the baffle. I had trouble butt welding two pieces of steel together. I just kept burning holes in it. So I actually put a plate behind those holes so that it looks like there's holes, but there's not. Okay, so here's trial number two. I've got my wood. I made the modifications. I stacked the wood in there with some paper, then lighter paper. I had a lot of trouble lighting it, not just because my lighter was lame and I had to trade it out, but once I got it lit, it would not stay lit. I even put a little kerosene on it just to really get it going, but it's like it wasn't getting enough air or it wasn't exhausting enough. It was very disappointing because after my modifications, I thought I would improve things, but it really went backwards. It never even got past not even close to 450 degrees that it got the first time. So I don't know what's wrong with this. I hope maybe Chris or someone can help me troubleshoot.